Hi guys, it's Baldrick here, and in today's episode, I'll be bringing you part 2 of getting into PC gaming. In today's episode, we'll be covering getting a monitor and getting your peripherals for your new PC that I have covered in the previous episode. If you have not seen that, I'll have a link in the description taking you to that video. Anyway, so we're going to get started off with monitors. So obviously you need a monitor to actually play games on your PC or do anything in general, unless you've got a really good sound setup that tells you exactly what you're doing. But anyway, you do need a monitor. So first we're going to go the budget way. If you already have a 720p monitor, you can just chuck that in and use that until you get the money for a better one. So that's your first option. I would recommend it and get a bit more money spent on your PC instead of getting a really bad monitor and just having, if you've already got one, just use that 720p one till you save up the money for a better one, I guess, because you definitely want to be upgrading from 720p in 2014. So now it comes whether you want to buy a TV or a monitor. If you want a sort of console-like experience but want the PC graphics, a TV is definitely a viable option. You can even just hook it up to your current TV. All you need is I'll get into the keyboard and mouse you need for that later, but that's really all you need to consider. Would you like to have your PC as a desk PC or a couch PC? Because you can have it for either, because Steam and many other programs work very well with the controller, and you can get pretty good keyboard and mouse setups for using on the couch. So now that we've got the TV out of the way, obviously you'd want to consider getting a TV with 1080p and 60 plus hertz. I would recommend getting it really depends on your living space, so I'd go 40 inches plus for your TV. So now comes to where most people are going to actually be, what most people are actually going to be considering, and that is a monitor. So what you're looking for on a monitor is a 60 hertz refresh rate, and anything lower than a 5 millisecond grey to grey response time. You really don't want to be getting any higher than that. If it's 6, yes, you can deal with that, but nothing higher than that, I would not recommend that. You're not going to have too much of a fun time. Unless you're doing just Word documents, but this is for gaming PCs. So now that you've got the response time and refresh rate at 60 hertz, you want 1080p plus, guys. There's no point getting a 720p monitor now in 2014 when 1080p is so much cheaper, and to be honest, it's really one of your only options unless you're buying second-hand monitors. So I'd recommend minimum, you can get them pretty cheaply. All the prices are different because soon this video is going to be old and obviously it won't apply, but I'd say about $150 could easily get you a 18 inch plus monitor. So this is what I recommend sizes for monitors if you're a casual gamer, anywhere from, I guess, 18 to 28 or 27 is going to be fine, but I wouldn't really recommend going any smaller than about 23 inches or 20 inches. You don't want to go any smaller than that, because then you may as well use a laptop. You want a decent size display, and trust me, it does make a difference. I went from 24 to 27, and even those few inches made that much of a difference to my gaming experience. So I guess size does matter in this case, and those few inches are going to make that much of a difference. So when you're considering it, maybe go for that bigger monitor and spend that much more money. So now you're going to ask me the question, is it worth it getting a gaming monitor? And my answer is, you do not need a gaming monitor. They are great to have. I've got one. They definitely make the experience a lot better. But if this is your first PC, you don't need one yet. You just need standard 60 hertz, because that is perfectly fine, and that is what most gamers play it. But if you're trying to get into competitive PC playing, which I don't see why you would if this is your first PC, but I would recommend getting a gaming monitor then. They do feel so much smoother, and you can definitely tell the difference, but it's fine with 60 hertz, and I'm not joking there, it's perfectly alright. So now we've got the higher resolutions. So if you've got a bit more money to spend, then I would recommend going a bit of a higher resolution than 1080p. If you did not know, the I guess standardized higher resolutions you can get is 1440p, and that's about the resolution is, I'm pretty sure, 1440 by 2560. And then you've got 4K, which is 3800-ish by, I'm pretty sure it's 2000 something. It's pretty high at resolution, so that's what people call 4K, because it's pretty close to 4000 pixels. So yeah. Anyway, 4K, I've never used it myself, but people do say it's very nice, and if you've got the money to spend on it, you may as well enjoy your games at the 4K resolution. But do not buy into one of these monitors unless the hardware on your computer can power this sort of resolution in gaming. And what I mean by hardware that can power it is basically SLI graphics cards, unless in the next generation of graphics cards they release single cards that can easily max out a 4K game, I wouldn't recommend getting a 4K monitor, because they're going to get cheaper when the hardware releases for them, so that's why I wouldn't recommend it. And if you think that a 980 is going to be good for a 4K display, I still wouldn't recommend that. I would still recommend having two SLI 980s to be chucked in there. Or even two 780s is definitely alright for 4K. Or even, I guess, a 770 could probably do it, but I wouldn't go any lower than that. For AMD, you're looking at two R9 290s, so it's a lot of hardware power right there to power that massive resolution. And then you've got 1440p. I have seen this because people in my house have this sort of monitor and it looks great. If you're not into competitive gaming, this is the resolution you really want to start aiming at. The picture is just beautiful. Anyway, obviously you need to incorporate the specs that I recommended before into buying this monitor. So now that I've covered all the monitor options, we've got one more option, and that is multi-monitors. So if you're, as many people watching this video are considering gaming on this PC, you're also probably going to be doing work on it. So if your work requires a lot of desktop space, then you might want to consider getting two. And that leads us to this next extreme gaming option, which is getting three monitors. That's up to you guys, but once again, it's a massive resolution. It's 5000 by, I'm pretty sure it's 1080, so it's a massive resolution. You need at least SLI 780s to run it. Once again, it's almost as high as 4K. So it does look pretty good. I've tested out three monitors at 1080p, and to be honest, it's alright, but you need to make sure all the monitors are the same, or at least two of the side ones are the same. You don't want to be mixing all different monitors, especially if you've got a gaming monitor. You don't want to bring down your refresh rate because you've got two lower end monitors. So that's what I recommend. But for productivity, three monitors is perfect. And also make sure your graphics card has the right outputs to actually power them. So good luck with that. It should be pretty cool playing at with free screens, but really only consider that if you're into simulators or stuff like that. Now to the final part of the video, which is the peripherals. So the peripherals I'm going to be covering is obviously the standard keyboard and mouse. The keyboard and mouse is, I guess, the most important peripherals you can get in PC gaming. So for the keyboard, I've never used a mechanical keyboard, so I can't really recommend you much there, but from what I've heard, they are pretty good, but they're also pretty expensive. So starting off, you can get a standard Microsoft keyboard. That's gonna do you fine for gaming, because what really matters is a mouse, and that's what I've learnt from my years of PC gaming. You want to spend at least $60 on a good gaming mouse. The keyboard doesn't affect you as much as the mouse, because the mouse is what you're gonna aim with, you're gonna click with. It also might help you click faster and shoot faster, so it's really good that you get a good gaming mouse. And obviously with a keyboard and mouse, there's going to be different options. It really depends on what sort of games you're playing. If you're playing MMOs, get an MMO based mouse. If you're playing first person shooters, get a really accurate mouse and just one geared towards first person shooters. And if you've still got money for a good setup with a good gaming keyboard and mouse, just go mechanical, I guess, for the keyboard. It's going to be the best for all your gaming needs. Or maybe if you're into MMOs, get a keyboard with a lot of, I guess, some macros and stuff on it. And I guess get the same with your mouse. So that's really it for this episode, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. And in the next episode, I'll be covering what softwares you need to get started on PC gaming. And I'll be talking a bit about Steam, Origin, and Uplay, and how that affects how you game, and how the whole PC gaming thing works with how you activate games and everything like that. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you liked it, please hit that like button. It will tell me that you enjoy this sort of series, and I'll try and bring some more series like this in the future. But do not forget, this series is still going, so if you want to see the next episode, please subscribe to my channel and you'll see it. Anyway, thanks for watching. Leave a comment what you thought. Have you had a good experience with PC gaming and getting your monitor and gaming peripherals? See you later, guys. Have a nice day.